Boo! Just kidding, I'm not a monster. I hope I didn't scare you too badly, because today we're exploring fright. Overwhelming, immediate fear. A sensation so disturbing that maybe, just for a second, you feel like you're dying. And that's today's question. Could you literally die of fright? The answer, unfortunately, is yes. First, let's look at what's happening when something scares you. Let's say you're sneaking through an abandoned amusement park late at night, like you do. Suddenly, a stained, white-gloved hand clamps down on your shoulder. In a split second, freak out! More specifically, your body activates what's known as the fight-or-flight response. It all starts with your thalamus, a structure of two walnut-sized bulbs that relay sensations to your cerebral cortex. At this point, your thalamus doesn't know if the sensory info it's just received, the gloved hand, is a real sign of danger. But since it might be, your hypothalamus steps in and activates two systems. The sympathetic nervous system and the adrenal-cortical system. The first uses nerve pathways to initiate reactions, and the second uses the bloodstream, and then it hits you. Your pupils dilate, you feel a surge of strength, and your heart rate skyrockets! But let's say this story has a happy ending. Let's say one of your friends just snuck up on you and happens to have what looks like a dead hand because they have a terrible sense of humor. You realize you're not, in fact, a clown's next victim, so you calm down. You've learned a valuable lesson about trespassing and friendship. Now, however, these bursts of fright can occasionally be more damaging than the perceived threat itself. Some doctors believe that if the fear is great enough, the jolt of chemicals rushing to your heart can cause immediate death, especially if your ticker wasn't top-notch to begin with. In Sir Arthur Conan Doyle's The Hound of Baskervilles, Sherlock Holmes investigates the case of a man who had a heart attack seemingly caused by the fear of a ghostly dog. The man, Charles Baskerville, was susceptible to this stress because of a heart condition. Over the years, scientists have studied this so-called Baskerville effect, and they found that cultural fears can increase this likelihood of sudden death. Another related concept comes from Harvard psychologist Walter Cannon, who published a 1942 paper attributing sudden death, which he called Voodoo Death, to an overactive nervous system. He believed this nervous condition was more common in cultures where forms of harmful magic were practiced. Otherwise healthy people, convinced that they were cursed, experienced a fight or flight response that never ended. Instead, the prolonged influx of adrenaline acted on the heart almost like a large amount of cocaine. It just shut the organ down. Then researchers at Johns Hopkins added another twist to the plot when they argued that experiencing stressful emotions could cause something that looks like a heart attack or heart failure, even when there were no clogged arteries or blood clots present. This work has a disturbing implication. Death could happen in the wake of any shocking emotion, from intense joy to deep anger. And hypothetically, that means we're all at risk of death by fright. But hey, our species actively pursues thrills and chills on a daily basis, from scary movies to rush hour traffic, and few of us die from these. At this point, research indicates that our chances of being scared to death are pretty low. And I have a question for you. What's the scariest thing that's ever happened to you that's also appropriate to post in a YouTube comment section? Let me know in the comments, and as always, stay tuned for more Brain Stuff. If you dare. I guess jazz hands are scary.